Jay Shrek.
And James.
James, where in the hell are we at today?
We're outside of Camp Verde looking for Mindeleff Cavates.
Mindeleff Cavates. Mindeleff Cavates, which was Cosmo's Mindeleff Cavates,
yes.
Correct? Now, from what we know, Cosmo's, which is one of the most awesome names for a guy in the 1800s, right? His job was to go to all the ruins in this area and draw maps. And in this area alone, he looked at 50 ruin sites. So the road that we came down made a big U-turn into this gate right here. Now what we're going to do is try to make the a dry crossing, right? So we're going to try to go down the top versus up across the river. Now we made the choice today to try and see if this was a pretty viable option. I'm sure it's easier to go down the bottom from what I can see, but you're going to get wet. And so, you know, it might be a better summer option. We'll give this a shot. If it doesn't work, our option is this. What we decided to do is, if it doesn't work, is then we'll just go to the bottom and we'll go across the river. So that's what we've decided to do. And I don't know if it's a viable option or a worse option or not, but we're going to find out. Coming up this ridge line, now right up here is where we're parked. Right up there. There's the fence post right there. See the fence? Right there. That fence post right in the center. We saw this trail coming down. Now we went all the way to the end and then winded back, but we found the trail. But we can already start to see some of the caves over here on this side. When we came across there, one thing we noticed was there was an option to kind of go down in a gully, the first one we ran into. And then we've came to the end of this and we got a sheer cliff on this side. So we're to the point where we're gonna have to make a choice to go and try to sidetrack and get ourselves down in here without killing ourselves. But I just come out from down there and you know, when you second guess yourself, James, you're like, maybe getting wet wouldn't have been so difficult. Well, I'm in the right.
Well, like I said, as long as on the other side of this street, rock.
See, we don't know. That's the only thing.
That's exactly it. That's so far so good. This is all definitely reversible land. So on the other side of that juniper, that might be. You know exactly why most people do.
Well, you know, though, if we'd have known this, I'd have went this way. If I'd have known. You know, if you said, okay, you got a choice, I'd have went this way. Because now the thing is, we don't really necessarily want to go down.
Yeah, right here, right?
Yeah, we want to go across.
Yeah.
Oh, so, let's mark this though, because this is our way out. I never heard of this place, and it's definitely not secret, but it's definitely one of the most unique places that we've been where they've actually carved, you know, their homes out of this rock, which is absolutely incredible. Another thing that I noticed that I want to be aware of today too is this. There's only a couple videos on this, but in both videos that I saw, they saw a rattlesnake. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to go in. This is the first one. We came down that ravine right there. That's how we got in. The first ravine, if you come down the hill, it's the first ravine. And that's how we're going to get out of here when it's time to go. But the first one already, we just came across this ridge and they're kind of stacked. And this is like the upper level. Let's go in this cave. Now, one thing we're noticing already is man, it's big and it's dark in there. So let's go in and take a look and see what we got. But I tell you what, this thing is huge. And if you don't have light, you're not going to be able to see in here. First thing I'm going to do is check for snakes. No snakes, James.
Not yet.
You can tell there's been bats in here.
There's bats and stuff for sure.
This floor doesn't still feel solid. Now here is a room back here. Man. You see back in here, James? Now this is the first building. What?
Bats hanging.
Oh yeah, there is a bat.
There's two.
There's bats on the ceiling. That's the name of a band, isn't it? Yeah. Look here. So, man, it's nasty in here. I can tell you that. They didn't have bats, though. So, be prepared for that. Look at this. This is incredible. Let's look over here. I mean, look, I'm standing up. But there's enough bat guano in here that we're standing on. Look at that. I mean, this is incredible.
All right. Yeah, it's real bad air in here, so keep that in mind.
This place here where they probably had a fire.
Yep.
I'm guessing right through here.
Possibly, yeah, we're back here.
Yeah, I tell you what. Yeah. The air is stagnant and it's bad. So let's move on to the next. Now one thing that's neat is seeing these holes in the ceiling. It's pretty spectacular. That's a big room back there. I mean, it's not huge. I mean, it's big enough for, you could get 10 people in there. And you know, they're just carved out all over here. And you look at how they did their stuff. Well, destiny calls me down there. Look there. There's cars. Get a picture of that car. You know, there's cars, so that's how close again. You know, it kind of reminds me a little bit of, you know, Black Mesa. So here's the condominium up here, second level, James. Now this wasn't the ancient's way of getting up here. I'm sure they had ladders, but this is definitely one that does not have a, this room's back there. I don't see any reason to get up there, to be honest with you.
I wouldn't go up there.
Okay. They're just endless rooms. Now this little area was carved out over here. This is really unbelievable. I can't even. There's a little hole there, and you know they. You know it's kind of like doing abandoned stuff. You ever done abandoned stuff? But it's man, this is somebody's home. People had they raised their families here. They had lives here, and you know so. You kind of feel privileged to be able to. To spend a little time in someone's home.
Yeah.
Hey, I F-bombed the bats, James. Because the thing is the coolest ones, the biggest ones you stumble on, definitely are also the ones that the bats like the best as well. Now, I can tell you, there ain't been anybody in this room for a long time. The tracks
that
are...
Yeah, that's a wild smell.
Oh, it's bad.
Be careful in that one, dude. Don't breathe too much.
The problem is I have to go in it, though.
Yeah, I feel you. But yeah, just be careful, dude. That's bad.
This is unbelievable. Look at this thing. And that little hole. What the hell did they put in that little hole?
I'm sure you'll get a good comment. Someone will know.
Well, this doesn't even look like material. that should be in this one. Oh, look at that. Oh my gosh. Here, let me see that camera, James. Well, I'm already in this stinking mess.
Oh, is it? Okay, cool.
Oh, unless you want to come in.
Oh, I'll come in a minute, but I'm just trying to
get... I wouldn't come in if I didn't have to. You know, what they put in that hole? And then look at this storage room back here. I don't even... Okay, I'm going to do it for you guys. Oh, there's a bat going to get me. There's a bat. There's a bat. Bat. Well, oh, geez.
He's coming out at me at some point.
Bats. Bats in my belfry, James. Oh my God, look how big that is. Is your camera on?
Yeah.
Man, there's two rooms back there. Now look over here, James, there's another room back there.
Oh yeah.
So let's... Here, give me that light if you would.
Yeah.
First, I want to do a snake check.
Oh, dude, did you see this?
The little cutout in the floor? Yeah. That's unbelievable, isn't it? Oh my God, look how big that is. I'll tell you what, crawling through those four rooms was probably one of the neatest things I've done for a while. What about you, James?
Yeah, that's pretty awesome.
I tell you what, because I thought we were dead-ended, and I thought I was going to have to kind of, I actually had planned in my head I was going to crawl across that cliff face, right? And then I saw that hole, and I looked around, and I saw that hole, and I was like, man, you definitely, if you're going to do this, you definitely better be ready to crawl. And then you also probably ought to be ready to make sure that you got a flashlight, because I tell you what, you're going to need one and you're not going to be able to see anything. These rooms are so big that you get back there, and the easy way to tell if the room's big, right, James, is how?
You tell me.
You smell bat guano, and I tell you what, you know you got a big room.
I just wanted to eat that.
Holy smokes. This stuff kills me. Big old piece of fish. You know, you don't get this every day, do you? This is unbelievable to be up in here. And getting up here wasn't easy. And getting down could go one of two ways. But how cool is this? This is about as neat as it gets. Of all the things we've done, me and James are talking about, this is really high on the list. And again, you're in a parking lot, and across from the river, you're in a park. So don't miss this one before it collapses.
So this is all home to the Sanawa people, spelled Sanagua. I've read that it's pronounced Sanawa, silent G. It's estimated they left here around 1400s. There's all kinds of speculation as to why they would leave these areas. Archaeologists say they probably moved down here after the volcanoes further up north where they originally were from, and settled in these cavates.
Wow, this is special. Look at that. That is special. What a breeze. Oh man. We're just, oh. You know, we've seen on other videos this rock floor, and I really wanted to see this badly.
Okay.
Follow me. Now this looks like, it looks like a well, and it definitely was dug. There's no doubt that it was dug. And so when you look in here and you see this, I'm guessing maybe water would run off the roof. Now that's a guess, but this definitely looks like it held water. And you can definitely tell it was carved. Never seen that on anybody else's video, and I'm sure it's on there, I just haven't seen it. But I'll tell you what, as you come through here, you know, you realize now that this culture was here, and I tell you what, it really is just fascinating. And each step's a good step, because if you come off this and you go down there, it's gonna be a bad day. You know, we're trying a new way out, so we went up this ravine up on the north side. This is one of them times when you, you know, you wish you might have taken a different trail, but you're already in. You know, right now, swimming across that Verde doesn't seem like a bad damn idea. Well, that was an ass kicker on the way out. So looking back and going, okay, what would I have done? How would I have done it? We didn't do it the way we read how to do it from the top down. Is it the smartest way? You know, if it was winter, yeah, because you probably wouldn't want to get wet unless you had some type of rubber raft, which I've seen on videos. Now you got two choices. Park at the top over there on that peak and walk down there and not get wet, or get wet and walk across the river. And I tried to get James to go ahead and go down and test it. And he wasn't in the test mode because he said he didn't mind getting wet once. And I said, well, you're gonna get wet twice because you gotta come back over. And what a great place. This was fun. I had a great time here today. Man, come up here and enjoy this regardless which way you go. What a fun day today. I think it's time to get in the truck and go home, James.
Yeah, definitely come check out Mindeleff Cavates.